Presenting the next award is the incomparable co-star of Hacks, Carl Clemons-Hopkins.
You can do that eternally. Thank you so much. Good evening. Good evening. All right, thank you. I'm Baptist, it helps. What is an easy way to get people to really pay attention to a serious message? Anyone?
Pay them money.
Pay them money. Excellent. I enjoy that. I enjoy that. Another easy way is to make them laugh. Make them laugh. Thank you. It always works. We've seen the impact of shows like Black-ish have had on this country. We've seen programs like Will and Grace and Modern Family and Pose and RuPaul's Drag Race connecting the LGBTQIA+ community and our allies. And then there's Hacks. A couple of women, a few very well-drawn supporting characters, thanks to our amazing writing team. And these characters are exploring issues like sexism, ageism, harassment. They're talking about it, and audiences are laughing about it, but most importantly, people are getting it. And yes. And there's Jean Smart. You can do that eternally as well. There is no shortage of good things to say about you. You are dynamic, you are the kind-hearted person we all strive to be, and with an acting resume that highlights your amazing accomplishments, a Tony nomination, 2 Critics' Choice Awards, and 4 Emmy Awards, including the one she got a couple weeks ago for a performance on Hacks. That's Hacks, the multiple Emmy Award-winning comedy that explores the bond that forms between a Las Vegas diva and an entitled outcast 25-year-old. And speaking of outcast 25-year-olds, it's time to talk about Hannah Einbinder. Character Ava on the show Hacks, which is brilliant and cringeworthy often at the same time. She's brash and deeply wounded, and to watch her is to love her. So far, Hannah Einbinder has been Hannah Einbinder, Einbinder. Please stop asking her. So far, she's been nominated for an Emmy, named one of Variety's top 10 comics to watch, and has performed her stand-up nationwide, headlining, coast to coast. You're doing it brilliantly. You are. For showing us all the painfully funny and sometimes just painful experiences and isms that women face, and for their performances that bring to light the issues women in film have been working on for decades, please join me in honoring Jean Smart and Hannah Einbinder.
Smart and Hannah Einbinder, everyone. Yes. How are we feeling good in the Max Mara here? I love
sweating,
it.
Sweating, panicked.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Good quality clothing. Keeps the heat in. First of all, I mean, I have questions, but let me just tell you right now. I imagined myself as Ava with Deborah Vance yelling at me. Whenever I watch the show, yeah, enjoy. Oh, if you could grab the microphone, there you go. We want to make sure we hear you. Oh, there you go, please. No, you don't want it? Oh, that's fine. I mean, you know, you can project, I'm sure.
Will you just get to the point?
Yes, I'm just saying, fine. just telling you right now, you yelling at Ava, it felt borderline erotic. I liked it. I liked it. That's all I'm gonna say first. Anyway, thank you. So, as a comedian, I over-identified with the show, which is traumatizing, but also very enjoyable. I would love to know, what did you two do to prepare for the roles? Other than a lifetime of working in comedy.
Okay. I read Michael Caine's Acting for Film.
Yep. Love that.
I cannot stress this enough. I am a clown. I should not be here, okay? I should be working the door. I did read an acting book, and I worked with a lovely woman named Margaret Turley. She helped me. But in terms of like the comedy thing, I love comedy. I, you know, have listened to albums since I was a kid. I love it all. I love every style, every genre. So I felt like kind of ready for the comedy world thing. I am a stand-up comedian. That helped.
Yes.
That is my answer. Jean.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you.
It was very good.
Well, I've just loved comedians all my life. I've loved watching comedians, you know, back to Phyllis Diller and Soupy Sales, and you know, anybody who can think, I'm dating myself. You know, even Bill Cosby. Okay, and then we'll move on from there. I didn't say that. But it just always looked like so much fun to me, and I was the family, you know, ham. I was you see family pictures, and I'm the one going, ooh, you know, in all the Christmas pictures. You know, I knew that I had to somehow find my own style, my own voice, and I didn't want to do, you know, an impersonation of anybody. And it was interesting because while we were shooting, I very rarely had an audience because of COVID. I was usually talking to just darkness.
Did the crew laugh?
Well, they were paid, yes. So that's what made it very safe and enjoyable, was that I knew there was absolutely zero risk involved of bombing. Did I answer your question at all?
Yes, no, okay. I loved it. I love everything you're saying, Jean.
You're hired.
Now, you were working on a set that had a lot of women in positions of power. How was that different to work in that kind of environment?
Well, for me, it didn't strike me particularly as being different. I'd worked with some really talented, I'm going way back to Linda Bloodworth Thomason, who wrote Designing Women. Yes, indeed. So that didn't particularly strike me, but when I look back, I mean, when I realized that our three powerhouse writer, you know, producers, Paul Downs, Jen Statsky, and Lucia Agnello.
Incredible.
And Paul and Lucia just got married in Italy. It was so cute. They've been together 14 years. They just got married, and their honeymoon got cut short because HBO said, get back to work. So, but you realize two of those three are women, and on top of that, Lucia directed almost every episode. So that was nice. It was really nice.
It was like the island where Wonder Woman is from.
Yes.
It was great. I feel really spoiled though, because I hadn't worked on another set before. So to me, that's just the way it is. Can you imagine?
Yes.
What is that?
Boy, are you in for a rude
shock. Awakening? Yeah. Mm. It's incredible because we got so lucky to be working with women who are as egoless as they are talented, which I think is apparent. Well, I hear that's not always the case.
In Hollywood?
In the old Holly weird. Mm-hmm. Okay. But thank you, Carl, one guy, awesome. it's absolutely one of these. It rocks, yeah. So.
You know, I am probably the least man-bashing person you'll ever meet. I love men. I had a great father who I just adored. So to me, men were always just great. Yeah. Just great. But I do, maybe it's just scientific, I do think that women in positions of power, at least the healthier ones, they don't feel like they have as much to prove. It's not as much about their ego as it is about just wanting to do what they love. And that's really nice. Nice atmosphere to be in.
So, I mean, you know, are there any specific practices on set that you would like to see spread far and wide in the industry?
Sacrificing animals or anything like that? Did we do any of that?
Well, I think, I mean, just generally, obviously, touching on what you spoke about with regards to IOTC, obviously, humane practices would be nice. sort of, those folks are sort of asking for the bare minimum. So that'd be great. I mean, you know, livable, a living wage, workable hours, people can see their kids, you know. And I think with respect to women, just like, you know, and I think Zendaya spoke about it beautifully. Can you imagine saying a sentence like that? That's crazy. Hello, you rock.
I had to hold my fangirling in.
Yeah, what? Wild. It's really about opening the door and getting people in. You know, like being incredibly conscious, you know, consciousness around inclusion and making sure that your crew specifically is incredibly female. We had two amazing camera operators, Ava and Money, Natasha. These two were, like, again, I have the privilege of just going, oh, this is the way it is. And that actually gives me a lot of hope, because I'm hoping that as we go on, that just will be the norm, because, you know, I am one of these, like, post-Me Too movement comedians / performers, and I do love living in a world where men are scared. And so...
Yes!
So I'm hoping for more of that.
Yeah, Jean, I had a complicated relationship with my father, so I'll take care of that. Everyone, congratulations again. Jean Smart, Hannah Einbinder, thank you so much.